Hello, viewer. My name's Don, and I'll be up front with you. I do like my wines, particularly reds, and in particular Cabernet Sauvignon. And this trip to the Clare and Barossa Valleys is about wine tasting. This map shows an excerpt of South Australia in yellow, and where the crosshairs point is the Barossa Valley. The Clare Valley is geographically distinct, but an easy car drive away. The Barossa Valley is northeast of Adelaide, and it's only a couple of hours at the most to drive. It's a beautiful drive through the farming lands of southern Australia. I've enjoyed many Clare Valley wines, but unfortunately didn't spend very long in this area. What you see is what you expect. Vineyards. I haven't done the racing trail, but it does sound attractive, though I don't know how I'd go after 10 or 15 wine tastings riding a bicycle. A traditional Australian farmhouse thrown in for a bit of interest. A misty morning in the vineyards. The Barossa Valley has three towns, of which I spent most of my time in Tanunda. Mengder's Hill gives a bit of a view over the valley. I sampled many wines in Tanunda, the town itself. It's the home of the world-famous Shepherd wines. The Barossa Valley was originally settled by British settlers, but large German migration brought in the wine-growing culture and fruit-growing culture, which flourishes today. Here is an early German family. For interest's sake, a picture of Tanunda in 1909 from a postcard. What a romantic vision this postcard presents. Let's look around the town itself. I did some same thing in the Zinfandel tea rooms, including the Zinfandel wines. Tanunda can be a sleepy town, but it hosts some national and international events. A particular attraction is the yearly Barossa Valley Wine Tasting Festival, which goes on for a week. Although the vineyards are ultra-modern, Tanunda has many reminders of the past. It's a relatively rustic, safe place to visit. This memorial to the Barossa pioneers states that British settlement occurred in the 1840s. Were followed by large groups of Germans in 1842. The memorial stresses that the settlers were God-fearing people who believed firmly in their religion. This memorial praises the settler who calms the plow horse with the plow to the side. Trip out wines, which I'm not really familiar with, began in the Barossa Valley and became quite famous after the 1850s. This award was given in 1891, so clearly they were winning national and international awards by the late 1800s. Look at the size of their production. One of their historic buildings taken in 2001. A panoramic view of Chepout Wines. It takes a while, so sit back and enjoy the music. The winery is imposing. Casks, and oak casks in particular, are used to mature many varieties of wines. Let's take a look. My, I would like that bottle of port. Some of the vineyard tasting rooms are quite elaborate, and this one provides a deep